When you tune in, so much love and peace to go around, so much love for the whole world on a beautiful day. You're watching Hello Nigeria, you are watching Hello Nigeria. Don't touch the dial, Hello Nigeria. Sit back and relax.
Welcome back on the show. Now, we already told you we'll be bringing an entrepreneur here to discuss entrepreneurial development. Kemi Ohi Ojebo, I hope I got her name right, is an entrepreneur who has been doing business for at least the last 12 years. And she's also a mentor and also a builder of young people. Welcome to the show, Kemi.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. So tell me, as an entrepreneur, why, you know, I know you have a professional side to you. I know before you started this, you were doing something else. But tell us, why did you choose, you know, to go toe that line?
Okay, the truth is, Nigeria as it is, we are a country that, when you look at it, entrepreneurship is what is going to push us to where we're supposed to be as a nation. And then I realized that most people don't know this, but we are always complaining about the situation of the country, why things are the way they're supposed to, why things are not the way they're supposed to be. But the truth is that it's supposed to drive us, to push us to where we're supposed to be as a nation. And then entrepreneurship helps you to channel all that anger and all that, you put it into your business, and then it helps you. It helps you grow the nation.
So if there's one thing that we've come to realize, is the fact that SMEs constitute about 90% of the businesses that are run in Nigeria.
Yes.
Matter of fact, they're the backbone of our economy.
Yeah.
And if we must push for economic development, we must focus on our SMEs.
Yes.
So let's look at some of the common mistakes that SMEs make. Can you highlight some of them? We know that you're an SME trainer, you're an advocate as well. So what would you say some of the common mistakes are?
One of the common mistakes that we have in SMEs is that The number one problem that we have is we're driven by money. That's number one. Now, I go into business. Of course, I want to make money. That's number one. That's the reason why I'm a business person. But we're not looking at it long term. We're looking at it for just the now. And so, okay, I just need to feed myself. I need to feed my family. And then I'm not thinking about something, growing something that is going to be for as long as possible.
Okay, so now we have SMEs growing in Nigeria, and you know, everybody is, you know, trying to do something for themselves, start up something for themselves. And these days we even have state governments, like in my state, Enugu State, the governor has always said this thing about increasing and improving SMEs in the state. Now, how much of funding, from your own view, have the SMEs in Nigeria gotten, from your own perspective, from, you know, your dealings with small business owners and entrepreneurs alike?
From my own perspective, it's really low, the level of the funding to get for SMEs is really, really low. So why I'm an advocate is the fact that you need to start looking inward. We've looked at, okay, we're always looking at government, we're always looking outside, we're always looking at what people can do for us. But now you have to look at yourself. What can you do with what you have? Now, the issue is that most times we feel like I need 1 million naira to start a business. That's the basic idea we have. But the truth is that whatever you're going to do, you have things around you that you can start with. Before somebody is going to believe in you and then decide to give you money to start up a business, they need to believe what, like, there's potential in what you're doing. Take, for instance, somebody wants to start like a shoemaking business, or he's telling you he needs 1 million naira because he needs to buy the shoe filer, he needs to buy so many things, but he forgets the fact that there are so many old shoes that he has. He could just take one and then brush it up, do something to it, and make somebody else look like, oh my God, are you serious? Is it the same shoe that I saw before? Before you know it, you're able to convince people, and then from there, funding gets easier.
All right, so I'm a young person, I want to contributes my quota towards economic development, seeing that SMEs constitute 90% of our businesses and 80% of employment opportunities within the country. And, you know, I'm thinking I want to do this thing. I'm so passionate about it, but I don't know what to do. So how do people decide what area of business that they want to focus on?
First off, I'll ask you, what is your passion? Because
my passion is eating food, but
okay, no problems. That could work too. But the thing is, I'll ask you, what can you do? If you're looking at, it's not just having a business, it's having a sustainable business. And that's where we get it wrong so many times. When you're starting up a business, you need to think of something that, okay, they wake me up in the middle of the night, I'm ready to do it. It's not something that, okay, I have to be thinking and I'll be grouchy. You're going to go through a lot of, there are going to be so many emotions. So you need to be sure that you are ready for all those things. Now, passion is one major key, because trust me, SMEs are not as glamorous as people think they are. So you need to be in it for the long run. It's not like, okay, I just want to dash in and dash out. Let me just see, everybody now is doing one business. Let me to go there. Because if you're doing it because of the money, that's why I mentioned money before. If you're doing it because of the money, immediately you start. Maybe the money starts coming in, but after a while, it stops. Then what sustains the business? You're now looking for the next best thing. It's not going to work.
And following up from that, there are people who have 9-to-5 jobs. We're starting to see these days that SMEs are what people call side hustle. Yeah. Now, for a lot of people, it is their main source of income. It is their main focus. But for some others who have a 9-to-5 job, you see somebody that is working in a bank or working in a corporate organization but sells jewelry on the side and has other things they do on the side. So for someone who wants to transition totally from 9-to-5 to focus squarely on their business, what would be some of the tips you'd give them on how to navigate this movement?
Okay, like I said also, when you are doing a 9-to-5, I know most people will tell you, I really don't want to do a 9-to-5. I'm only trying to gather up money to be able to start up what I want to do. The thing is, if you're living a 9-to-5, you understand the fact that 9-to-5 gives you a steady income. At the end of the month, there's always something. Mm. Now, if you're going to leave your 9-to-5, make sure that you have something to fall back on, just in case the business doesn't pick up as fast as you expect it to do.
Something to fall back on, do you mean financially?
Yes, financially. Yes,
okay, so
financially.
Like
yes, yes. So you have to have savings. And then we're always thinking business is just like that. You start it today, you begin to make money tomorrow. Sometimes it might not be like that. Okay, now, so I've been in business for 12 years. And if you don't have that passion, if you don't have that staying power, if you don't have that vision, it's very hard, because if I'm talking to you about my business, it's not moving, and I'm talking to you about it, the only thing that is sustaining me in that business is the fact that I'm seeing a picture that you're not seeing. Mm. And then because I haven't gotten to that place that I want to be, I will keep pushing myself. I will keep pushing and pushing and pushing, and I keep telling myself. And then another mistake some people make is, oh, you're going into a fashion business, or is making money for you, let me to go into fashion. Okay, maybe I have the passion for fashion. Now you started your own, and in 2-3 months, everybody's already hearing your name. I've been in it for like 5 years, and nobody's hearing my name. And then I'm beginning to compare myself with you, and I'm feeling maybe I'm doing something wrong. Sometimes it might not be that you're doing something wrong. It might just be everybody's time and chance. It happens to everybody. So you have to have that staying power.
Okay, so with the growing number of SMEs in Nigeria and your experience with young people, those who you mentor, those who have started under you, you know, who you have trained, what are the top three issues you've noticed that they have, you know, as entrepreneurs?
The first one is, like I said, staying power. Some people think once I start, in fact, most people, the only reason they want to start a business is because they want to start making money. And so there's that frustration. I've started it 1 month, 2 months, I'm not seeing anything. They're frustrated. So number one is they didn't put at the back of their mind that this thing might take long. Because truly speaking, it's not the way we always expect it to be. Sometimes you get some blows that you didn't expect. It will take your balance. Your ability to stand up again is one very main issue. Is a very, very big issue. Then another thing is free. It kills, that word, it kills so many businesses. So, because I know how to make hair, my mom comes, please make my hair for me. I do, it's my mom now, I make it for free. And then my auntie comes, my uncle, all those things. So the thing is, you need to make sure you begin to monetize those things. You say you don't have money, but you have to monetize. Then the last one that I think is comparing yourself to other businesses.
All right, so more importantly, if there's nothing you take away from the conversation, you must remember that you need to envisage what you should expect. Don't go there because somebody else is doing it. And the one that excites me in all of this is that free one. You know, put a price tag to what you do.
Yeah.
Rather than having somebody, you know, rendering their services for free, what people get for free sometimes they don't appreciate.
Yes.
And they don't put a value. So put a value to what the service you offer, no matter how little. And business moves on when family and friends pay for it. Thank you so much for joining us.
You're
how can people follow you on social media?
Okay, so I'm on social media at PB Essentials.
All right, PB Essentials is the handle to follow on social media.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.